Hello friends, in this video I am going to show you how to install root in Ubuntu 18.04. We will be installing root from the scratch. So first we will be downloading root from the Sun website. So let's search Sun root, and here you can get either pre-compiled version or the source file. We will be using source file. So let's go to all release. Here you can go to any one of these, and right now I will be installing this 6.10.4. So once you click this, you can see all the compiled version, like for example this for Ubuntu and Linux and CentOS. And in this is a new laptop in which I have installed the Ubuntu, so there are no prerequisites and all those things. So first we will download this root and save this. So I let it download, and now to install this root or to compile this root, we need some prerequisites. Means there must be some software which should be there. So you can get the list here, and according to various Linux you can get the list of the software which you need to install, and they will also give you command, for example this one. So in this is for Fedora and this one is for Ubuntu. So this thing works in Ubuntu 18 also. So we will be using apt repositories. So this are the required packages which must be installed, and the others, these are optional. So we will be using terminal to install these things. So just paste this, but you can see there is this. Okay, let's go. So it will ask your permission. Okay, so I'll pause here and wait for it to finish the download as well as this. So this installation has been finished. So just to make sure that all of these are installed properly, I will just put them, because this slash may create a problem, but right now it seems to have worked fine. So I will just paste this and then separately paste these two along with that. Okay, so a space, and then I will put them. So now this looks same as this, and I will just enter, and you will see all of these are already installed. So I don't think this slash is making any problem. So let's install these optionals also. They may be required for some other packages. You can skip this if you don't want them. Okay, so this thing will download around 89 MB, and okay, so now it will download and install them. It will take some time, and this thing is almost about to download. So once these things are finished, I will come back. Now the prerequisites are installed properly. We can now start compiling, because this root source file is also downloaded. So this thing is downloaded in the document. So what I will be doing, I will just make a product folder here, products, and mkdir products. So now I will copy from downloads this file whose name was this root. cp download root. I will copy this into this products, and now we need to extract. First go to products, and extract this thing to, okay, so this is like, you can see here we have this root tar file. We need to extract this, so you can use this command tar minus xzvf and root. So we will create this. So we will create a folder named root 6. So we will create this folder named root 6.10.04, and so all these files will be extracted into that folder. So this folder, this root 6.10.04, this will contain all the files. So but we want to install into a separate folder, so we will create a folder named root and we will go into root. Okay, so this is empty. So now we need to use cmake. So we will be using this folder root which has this source file. So this folder has source files, and most importantly I will use this command dall and make it on, means all the libraries will be compiled if possible. I mean, if the prerequisites and the hardware software prerequisites are there, they will be compiled, otherwise they will be skipped. I need few, sometimes you use some codes which require various libraries and you don't even know the names of those libraries, so in that case it will be helpful. So I will just use this command dall and make them all of them on, otherwise you will just name that thing like minus d math more is equal to on, like that, but I am making all of them on. So now this thing will compile and it will just take some time, not much, and once it is compiled then we can do installation. So like for example, few of the things may not be installed because they may not have all the prerequisites. So now we can build. So we can use this cmake minus build. It will install it here, that's why this dot minus j. Now after this j, you can type the number which shows a number of cores in your computer or laptop. I currently have 8 cores, so I can type 8. So we will be, so let's try this. So it will be faster if you use all of your cores. Okay, so it will take some time. This thing is showing in percentage. I will pause this video for that time. Now the root has been built, so we can just check whether it works properly or not. So if you right now type root, it will not work. So for that we need to run this source file, and so let's try. So it ran properly, and now if you type root, it will open on this interpreter of root, and this has been successfully opened. But if you try to open it in any new terminal, for example this terminal I just opened new, and you type root, it will show there is no software like this, but here it will, it is showing the root is there because we have ran this file, this root.sh. so to make this thing permanent and run root whenever you want any folder, you need to write this thing into bashrc file. So that thing you can find actually here also. So let me see if it's here, otherwise okay. So that thing is this, you need to export this thing into the bashrc file. So this is the main address which you need to get where your root is installed. So if we see our root is installed here, so we will write pwd and this thing, copy this address and control C and just paste it here. It can be different for you according to your name and PC. So now other things will remain same because they are just variable, you don't need to change them. So just copy this thing and now we need to edit bashrc file, so that you can find in the home. So let's go to cd, and so in home you will find a file bashrc. So let's use gedit, and so this is dot bash, yes, bashrc, and so this is the file bashrc. You don't have to disturb the content already there. You just at the end you just paste these lines. So this is just command for root, and this root is this address where your root is installed. If you have installed root of various versions, you can do that. Just give this name according to that root and you can run various roots according to this thing. So just save it, and so now even okay, so let's open some new terminal and try this. So it does not show any error, it means the bashrc file is running fine, and if there is some error in the path or so, it will notify you here. So just type root and this thing works. So this was the tutorial in which we have showed how to install root with all the libraries enabled. And this is in Ubuntu 18.04 and we built it from the scratch. Thanks for watching.